This is the Tribe on 99 FM.
Welcome back to the Tribe exclusive on 99 FM. KP Illis is in the building. What was that title of your mixtape again? Turn off your TV.
Kill your television.
Kill your television. Welcome back to the Tribe, man.
It's great to be back, and it's long.
No, we see you've even grown. Yeah. Even you've grown. You look like a young man. When you came around the first time, we're like, it's a. Which child is this?
This is a school kid.
The last time we spoke was when you were dropping your Kill Your TV Volume 3.
Yeah.
It's done. That mixtape has done so much.
It has.
Wait, I just want to ask, how come that one's worked and the other two sort of kind of almost did but didn't? Volume 1 and Volume 2, what was the difference?
Okay, Volume 1 was badly, like, I mean, I had to record it with a Skype microphone at home, but I just wanted to get music out.
Yes, just to do something.
So Volume 1, I mean, you gave it to radio. They were like, dude, try again. But Volume 2, that was okay. I think Volume 3, because I tried to do much more for Namibian people in terms of, I did a song with Exit.
Yeah.
You know, I got a song produced that has a Kwaito fever to it.
And then you still killed that beat.
I spoke about some Namibian topics. So I learned a lot. So it was just putting the stuff that I've learned in talking to guys like Exit and them, just putting what I learned into practice.
Yeah,
I think that made 3 stand out. No, also, it was better, like, sounded better.
Yeah, but quality-wise, yes.
Yeah, yeah. I got more producers, Willie G, Morgan the Syndicate.
Uh-huh. So more flavors from the land of the
exactly,
bread.
Exactly. That the sound mixed with the just what I learned made it a much better thing.
It's quite a powerful one. Plus, you won an award with that mixtape.
Tell us
about that experience. Did you ever think? Did you ever, when you were busy with one, were you ever like, I think one day when I get to 3.
I didn't even want, I thought it was going to end at 1. That adding the Volume 1 was just for effect. Like, one of my homies, you know, when you're chilling with those drunk homies, everyone has an opinion. So it's like, if you add Volume 1, that would be hard. So I was like, you know, and then he did it. He belabored it. So let's just add Volume 1 to make him happy.
Yeah, just do it. Yeah.
And then we'll delete it later. It came out. But I never ever thought of entering. I just thought, okay, let me make some music. My goal was, one day I'll make music with a real microphone.
Yeah.
I was still recording.
As far as you were thinking. Yeah.
We were like, one day I'm going to be in the studio. Then we're done, isn't it? And then we finally got somewhere, but never really thought of winning.
Now, we look forward to your future. We really do. You've bought us 3 mixtapes. Even though the first one, you're saying the quality was off, we still enjoyed it very much. And you kept on bringing it back until the third one, until you won an award at the NAMA Awards.
Yeah.
And now you're going to work on your album. So obviously, the mixtapes, Kill Your TV Volume 1, 2, 3, we've heard it. We are looking forward to the album. We want to know what KP Illis is all about when it's sick like that. So no pressure. Honey. It's okay. No pressure. So KP, thank you very much for coming through.
Thanks for having me.
And as soon as it drops, you know, right? You know where to find us.
Same way we did it with the mixtapes.
That's what it is. That's what it is.
I think we'll have some releases and
stuff
like that.
You're with Mshashi now. That's how they roll.
Yeah, we'll have some events and
stuff. Absolutely.
Even just there by my house.
So there you have it, ladies and gents. Just a little touch base with hip hop and what's happening in that world. KP Illis right here on the Tribe exclusive, and that's a wrap.
This is the Tribe on 99 FM.
Tribe on 99 FM.